Hey guys, I'm here at the top of the world. And look at those beautiful eagles behind me. You see them? You see them? But I have many here in Africa. I'm getting a lot of slack about investing with margin. Some people understand or supportive, but most dislike it. And also dislike the videos where I explain that I think it's a good idea to use margin when investing in Tesla. Such beautiful birds. Let me sit down. I did do a lot of more thinking on it as I got a margin call. And I did lose some shares, and it was a warning shot across the bow for me to really check whether all my premises are right, and also do some more research. And I've come to the insight that I did make some mistakes in my previous videos. For example, I was saying that, yes, I think it's smart to buy on margin, and also if it then 10x's, then instead of selling the shares, you just take out a margin loan against the shares. That's really wrong, I think, because the moment, because after something 10x's, it can actually lose 80% of its value again. So let's say you do a high margin right now and you do double or triple the amount of shares that you have in equity and investment, then you have a loan that's double or triple as big as the amount of equity you have. So you leverage 2 to 3. Let's say it does 10x. So that means that, let's say you invest 100k in Tesla, you're gonna invest, what, for example, 300k, but 200k is borrowed. Then it does a 10x. Well, now you're investing with 300k, it does 10x, it becomes 3 million, the value of your shares. But you do have a loan of 200k. So then you can borrow a lot more against your shares. So let's say you play it safe, or so you think, and you're gonna borrow only 25% of the amount of equity you have. Well, your 3 million in Tesla shares, you can borrow, if you want, 20% against it. That would be then 600,000 loan against your 3 million. But once, if something did 10x, it can correct with 80%. And so, let's say you take out a loan of 600k or so, or 700k, you think you're safe, and you use that 600k to invest in something else. Well, that 3 million can drop 80% and go back to 500k. Even more, it could do a 90% quick correction and then go back up. It goes to 300k, so you lose half. You get seriously margin called there, and the money is in other investments. You have to sell either these other investments again immediately, or you have to sell Tesla shares forcibly at 90% discount. I have to sell them again. That's not a good idea. The moment to invest, especially with margin, is when you see a great opportunity. And is Tesla a great opportunity after it 10x? No. So you should also not take a margin loan against it. No, that's not wise. What you should do, if it 10x's, then probably it's a much bigger allocation in your portfolio, is to sell it off. The first shares you sell will all go to paying off your margin loan. That's the first thing you do also. After that, it's pure equity, no margin loan anymore, but it's still going to be a very big exposure in your portfolio, probably way too big compared to other opportunities that are available that they have not 10x'd. And so you have to scale down your exposure. That's the rational thing to do there, meaning not only pay off your margin loan, but actually sell a lot more than that of Tesla stock. That's the right move. So that's the first thing that I came into insight. Another thing was that Yes, it is risky. When you max out your margin and you get margin called, it's a very you make a lot of losses. The deeper it goes, like you really make a lot of losses because, and you can't make that back up because the moment it starts to like you get your margin calls, it means you're maxed out in leverage, and actually your broker is saying you're so maxed out. You need to like sell some shares to pay down your margin loan because we don't allow so much leverage. And so the but you're like double or three times as much invested as the equity you have. So let's say it's cut in half. Yeah, you do you're investing with a lot more, but as it goes down, your equity really gets slashed. You lose a lot of your equity because you're investing a lot with a lot more money. And then when it gets slashed, your equity is like a lot valued a lot less, and it goes back up. Your broker does not allow you to borrow as much because it's only allowing you to borrow double or triple as much compared to your equity, eh? But your equity is valued a lot less. So if you go back up, and you're at the same price level again. If you don't use leverage, you didn't make any losses. But if you have used leverage, and even if you buy back a bit leverage on the way up, and you keep your leverage maxed out, and still you will not make back that money. My calculations show that you lose about 30% of your shares with each such whipsaw, and you lose about 20% of your equity with each such whipsaw. And whipsaws, of course, can last. They can like do it more than once, whipsaws, before the thing breaks out to the upside. Huh? So every whipsaw you lose that. So there is high risk with leverage, but I do think it's worth taking that risk, but only when there is an amazing opportunity where you believe that the chance is very low, it will go lower. Huh? When you believe that. The odds are very high for it to go up because there is only a very small window to invest in something, and that's when it's seriously undervalued, huh? With your own money, but especially with money from someone else that you borrow, huh? And so, and that's the case with Tesla here, huh? After it has moved sideways for 5 years. It's still at $210, $220, a price that it reached already in 2014, 5 years ago. It has been a very bad investment for the most investors. Very few investors were investing in Tesla 6 or 7 years ago when it was like only $10, $20. Or 8 or 9 years ago, it was also $10, $20. So, I do believe that right now it's the time to be aggressive. And I made many mistakes, as you all have seen if you followed my work. I should have gone all in to crypto when it went to 4K. I was making videos about going all in, but I didn't go all in because I believed the bottom was not in. I did go 80%, but then it drops more and my exposure is only 50%. That's when I make videos like that I should go all in, but I didn't do it. I didn't invest anything more when Bitcoin Cash dropped from 250 to 80, like around $100. I make videos, guys, this is buy this, marry BCH. Buy it, but I didn't buy it myself. I should have at least raised my exposure from 50% back to 80%, but I was frozen, huh? And that was a mistake. Even though I believed the bottom was not in, it was still justified to really raise my exposure, and I said so to my followers, but I didn't act on it, huh? So I believe that be greedy when others are fearful is certainly the case with Tesla here. Once it went below 200, and still today, even though it went back up to 260, from 180 to 260, and now back at 210, there's back a lot of fear and that it will go a lot lower. So be greedy when others are fearful, and buy more, and make sure that like if you buy as much as that you're scared, huh? That's the right thing to do when you're scared. I feel fear buying Tesla and buying Tesla so aggressively, but that's the right feeling to have. Fear of losing everything, huh? That's the right thing to do. Huh? Yeah. But also act on it. Not only make YouTube videos for your followers, actually execute it yourself. Or not, if you don't make YouTube videos, talk to other people how great an opportunity is, but actually not really like acting on it yourself. That's a mistake I've made many times. Similarly, when it's like valued very highly, talking to other people that it's gonna crash a lot and likely gonna go down a lot and a very long bear market is to be expected, but then not sell a lot yourself is a big mistake that I also made at the peak when crypto peaked out in 2017. I scaled back my exposure from like 90% to 70%. That was really not enough at all. I should have sold a lot more. So I'm learning, and the problem in my case is, if you look at my YouTube videos, the comments are always like wrong. The majority of the people really, and even of my followers, disapprove of the right actions. And I can really see it as the case today also with investing in Tesla, especially with using margin. It's really disapproved of, and I think it's absolutely the right action, and I'm also acting on it. So I hope that may inspire you guys also to take the right action here. That was it. Bye. A view of Nairobi.